cruise lines resumed sailing in U.S. waters for the first time since COVID-19 washed ashore. The American Queen Steamboat Company is set to resume travel between New Orleans and Memphis. Let's talk about this. Hey cruiser, Boni here with the latest cruise updates and welcome back. If it's your first time and you have not yet subscribed, please do so and hit the notification bell below. A small U.S. cruise liner returned to the waters over the weekend, making it the first industry voyage in American waters since the corona pandemic hit early last year. The American Cruise Lines Costa Cruiser Independence departed Amelia Island, Florida for a seven-day trip to Charleston, South Carolina. The Independence will usually hold 100 passengers, capped its capacity at 75%. The cruise line is able to resume operation because it has smaller ships enough to bypass the current sailing directive from the CDC. Passengers and crew members must also test negative for the coronavirus within 4 days of arriving on the ship. Another small U.S. ship line, American Queen Steamboat Company, is also set to resume sailing this Monday. Unfortunately, with sad news, MSC cruise ship catches fire off the Greek coast. Plumes of smoke were seen billowing out of the MSC Lyrica, which has been moored at Corfu port since January, according to the Greek news site in Kathimerini. 51 crew members were said to be on board the 2,300 capacity vessel when the fire started, but no one was injured. The fire started in one of the ship's fiberglass lifeboats, and a preliminary investigation to ascertain the cause of the fire is pretty much underway. Footage shows two lifeboats attached to the ship's starboard side had caught on fire before firefighting vessels could respond to the inferno. The cruise industry has been anchored down for months amid the coronavirus pandemic. And you already know that Royal Caribbean's Quantum of the Seas resumed sailing in Singapore last year with local government cruise safe certification. The certifications confirm 3- and 4-night ocean getaway meets the comprehensive health and safety requirement developed by the local government. The company also recently announced that Israeli holidaymakers would have the chance to set a new course for adventure this summer when Odyssey of the Seas makes her debut in that country. Royal Caribbean begins sailing from Israel for the first time in May with fully vaccinated crew and guests over the age of 16 years. Regarding the U.S. sailing, Royal Caribbean itself will not now return until at least May 31st, with Celebrity Cruises and Silver Sea Cruises set to resume operation at the same time. But this may change, of course, depending on what CDC directs. Before we go any further, I'd like to bring two feedbacks from the previous video. I asked which is the next destination on your bucket list, or where do you cherish to visit again when all this is over? And I have two comments from Manjeri. You say that you like to visit Spain and Portugal. I've been actually to these two places and I enjoyed the dessert there. And Elizabeth Charles, you say that you like to visit Alaska and Sydney. These two countries are also in my bucket list, and I hope when all this is over, we'll get to visit again. Out of this video, I'm bringing also another question where I'll ask you to put a feedback in the comment section, and I'll be highlighting your feedbacks on my next videos. Thank you so very much, and let's proceed. Let's keep going, actually. Congratulations to the UK, as cruise lines are expected to be able to restart domestic voyages from the English port on May 17th, a group of MPs has been told. The Maritime Minister, Robert Coates, appeared at a virtual meeting of the All-Party Parliamentary Maritime and Group to confirm the news. Following the reopening plans laid down last month by Prime Minister Boris Johnson, British will also be able to resume international travel at the same time. Robert Coates told MPs that the government is working with home nations to get UK domestics cruising started. Meanwhile, voyages between English ports looks likely to restart on the earliest date proposed for easing many travel restrictions. Robert Coates says the domestic move would help the cruise industry restore confidence and demonstrate the robustness of their protocol for the passengers and also for the crew. The announcement comes after P&O Cruises, the leading British cruise line, cancelled all its international voyages for the summer and said it will instead run short cruises around the United Kingdom. I know how badly we all want to cruise. Hopefully, in the coming few days, we'll get some more good news. Without further ado, let me know in the comment box below if you're ready to start cruising, or will you wait for a while? Do let me know in the comment section below. And until you see me in the next video, keep calm and stay safe.